Hi everybody, this is Julie Bean with Beadaholic, and in this video I'm going to teach you how to make the Laguna bead woven earring. So this is what it looks like up close, and we can see a couple of the elements here. We've got some beautiful prestige crystal, so that's that beautiful light turquoise and Pacific opal crystal in there. We've got some pip beads, which are really fun. I love pip beads. And we have some two-hole CzechMates diamond beads, and we also have some Mayuki delicas. So I'm going to teach you how to do this from start to finish. It's a made-up stitch of mine, so it's a design that doesn't really use a traditional bead weaving stitch, but we are doing a bead weaving project for it, so I do want to show you the process from start to finish. So what you're going to need is you're going to need some crystals. So I have 4mm bicones, and these are prestige. And so we've got the 4mm in light turquoise, and we have the 3mm in Pacific opal shimmer. So let me show you those guys up close. So you can see their sparkle, really pretty there. So they're going to catch the light, so that's going to help with some of the shine. And then we've got the two-hole CzechMates diamond beads. We've got the pip beads. We have 11-0 Mayuki delicas, and we've got a pretty gold, and we've got a pretty cream. And then we've got our finding here, which is our earring hook, and we're also going to be using a 2-inch head pin, and we're going to cut off the head and turn it into an eye pin, but not a traditional eye pin. One side is going to be a little bit bigger than the other. And this is 22 gauge wire, and that's going to be important, that's 22 gauge. And then for our thread, we are using Wildfire, and we're doing the 0.006 size. You can do the point, this one size smaller as well if you want, if that's what you've got. For our tools, we have a beading needle. I'm using a size 10. A size 12 will also work. I'm using a 10 so you can hopefully see it a little bit better here on camera. You're going to need a little pair of snips. And then for when you get up to the findings portion of this, you're going to need chain nose pliers. You're going to need cutters, and I'm using a wire looping plier. You could also use a round nose plier. So those are going to be your tools. So to begin this project, what we're going to do is we're going to thread our needle with 36 inches of the thread to start with. We're going to pick up one of the two-hole diamond beads, and we're just picking up by one hole. We're going to pick up one gold Mayuki Delica, another diamond bead, another Delica in gold, another diamond bead, and another Delica. So this is what we have on our beading needle right now. We're going to take these and slide them down. So you have a tail of about 6 to 8 inches. Now what we're going to do is we're just going to go back through our beads. So I've just taken my needle and I've gone right back through our beads. And I'm creating a loop. And then if you see this on my mat, I'm just going to go ahead and make a circle with my little loop. And you're just helping your beads along. You're gonna do a lot of passes through these beads. I'm not tying a knot off at this point because I don't wanna be hindered by that knot. So I don't wanna end up in another pass being stuck where I can't go through a bead because I have a knot. So you're just gonna make sure that you have your thread out of your way, your tail. We're not doing anything with it right now, but we're gonna go ahead and just have these form a nice little point. So now we're gonna go ahead and go through our diamond bead again, pull our thread, and now we're going to jump up to that next hole. So you see that hole up top? This is why we love two-hole beads. We're going to jump up to the next hole, and so now we have a little thread bridge right there, but don't worry about it, it's going to get hidden. You're not going to be able to see it. So we're just copying what we did in this first earring. So we have that center now. And of course the beads are a little floppy because we haven't anchored them yet. So now what we want to do is we want to go ahead and add a gold Delica, another triangle bead, I'm sorry, not a triangle, diamond. And then after that, we're gonna add a pip bead, and we want to add it, like if you see on my table, I want that gold side up and I want to go through the right hand side of it. And this is important so that you have all the golds facing you if that's the pattern you want. You always alter the pattern or use different beads, of course. All right, and now we're going to pick up another diamond bead. And another Delica. Okay, so this is what we've got on our needle now. We have a gold Delica, a diamond bead, a pip bead with the gold facing up, and we got another diamond and another Delica. And so now what I wanna do, you can see right here, I'm gonna get that other tail out of the way. Now we're gonna go through the top hole of the diamond bead, one bead over. You got those three diamond beads in the center. Okay, so go ahead. This is gonna create your first little archway. And again, your beads, you're just gonna have to coax them in the right direction to begin with until you string everything on. All right, so that is our first little segment we have, and we're gonna repeat that and do that for all of the diamond beads you have right here so that we have a nice round. So we're gonna repeat it. So we've got a gold Delica, a diamond bead, a pip bead with the gold facing up, another diamond bead, another Delica. Got all of those on your needle. You're gonna go one over now so that you're going through that top hole of that next diamond bead over. Don't slide off. Okay, there we go. All right, so we've got the next section. You see how we're just building at this point. Okay, one more to go on this round. So let's go ahead and do Delica, diamond, pip, diamond, Delica. And here we go for that last center diamond. Okay, so we've done the round. Now I'm gonna lay this down on my table so you can see where we're at. So this is what your piece should look like right now. To begin our next row, what we're going to do is you see this little bead right here, that gold bead. We wanna go through the gold bead and the diamond bead next to it and come on out, because we need to jump up to our next level. So when you're working with these two hole beads, you're always jumping up to the next level. So we're gonna now go to the top hole of that diamond bead, and we're gonna have that thread bridge there, but again, we're not gonna really see it. And now what we're going to do is we need to create our first archway with our pretty prestige crystal. So to do that, we wanna pick up a gold Delica. We wanna pick up a cream one and one of our 4mm bicones. And now we want another cream Delica, another gold Delica. And now I've changed direction, so now I'm working this way. There's our first archway. Okay, so now we've got a pip bead. So what I wanna do is I wanna create something that's gonna help anchor this pip bead because I don't want him flopping so much. So I'm not gonna use a crystal because that's gonna just push him out too far. I'm just gonna create a little bridge here, and my little bridge is gonna have a Delica, a gold Delica, three cream Delicas, and another gold Delica. So that's what I've got on my needle. And now I'm just gonna pull that through. I'm going to now have that little anchor behind him, and that's gonna help him sit upright. Okay, so now I have a little archway here that doesn't have a pip bead. So I'm gonna go back and do my crystal pattern on this one. So we're gonna do a gold, a cream, a 4mm light turquoise bicone. We're gonna do another cream and another gold Delica. So that's the pattern I have on my needle. And you see that sparkle and shimmer, which is so pretty. Okay, so now we're just gonna go over. You see that little top hole of that diamond bead is waiting for us. So we're just going to go through that. Okay, and pull it through. And that's what we've got so far. All right, now we're to another pip bead. So we're not going to use the bicone. So we're going to do the pattern of one gold and three creams and one gold. Okay, that's on our needle. Go through it. And I'm making sure that it sits behind my pip bead. I want my pip bead facing forward because that really pretty gold color. All right, another archway. So this one does not have a pip bead. So we're going to do a gold delica, a cream delica, a bicone, a cream delica, and a gold delica. And now we're going to go through the top hole of that triangle bead over here. Not triangle, excuse me, I keep saying triangle. My goodness, diamond. Okay, so that's what we've got now. And now we're going to lift up this little pip bead so he's out of our way, and we're going to do the other combo that we have for behind pip beads, which is gold, cream, 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 gold, and go right behind him. Okay. Get our tail out of the way. All right, so this is what we have now. If you look at that, we're going to compare it to our original, and you see we're not quite done yet. So when I'm playing with bead weaving patterns, I often look at them and think, well, what can I do more? Is there something more I can do to make it even more interesting? And I thought I could add an extra little layer, which is where I bring in my 3mm bicone. So you see I've got two little archways here, two little bridges. So that's what we're gonna do now. Okay. So to do that, we're going to go ahead, pick this up. And for this pattern, we are going to do gold, cream, 3mm bicone, another cream, and another gold. So that's what we've got on our needle now. And we're just going to again cross over, and we're going to go through this hole right here of that diamond bead. So you'll see what this looks like when it lays on top of it. Okay. Okay, so that's what we've got. So it just created a little more dimension, a little more interest, a little more shimmer. Now I'm not going to do another row behind this pip bead because it's going to push it out too far. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to run my thread through my existing beads and my diamond bead till I come out the other side. And that actually gives your design a little extra strength too. All right, so now I'm back to this segment here. We're just working our way around. We're gonna do gold, cream, 3mm bicone, cream delica, gold delica. Okay, and then we're just gonna go over to this triangle bead, and since we know we're going to run our, not triangle, excuse me, diamond, we know we're going to run through those beads anyways that are the next segment, we're just going to go ahead and go through all of them, and our diamond, like so. Okay, now what we're going to do, so we've got the last one to do here. So we're gonna do gold, cream, 3mm, cream, gold. All right, and we're gonna go through this. And we're gonna lay that flat so you see what we have. Just a little bit more to bead weave, and then we're gonna tie off our tails. So right up here, you see how this is connected. So we have our piece right here. This is our earring. Of course, it's finished. And if you look here, there's a little something extra happening. What we're doing is we're creating a way to attach that crystal dangle, which will eventually allow us to attach our earring hook. So when you're doing some bead weaving, you always need to think, well, how am I going to take this piece and attach it to my finding? And so that's what we're going to do right now. So to do that, we are going to go up. Here, let me show you like this. We're going to go through our, it'd be easier to show you from the back actually. You can see it from the back here too. We're going to go through the gold delicate and one cream. Okay. Now we're going to string on three of our gold delicates. We're going to skip over a cream, the center cream, and go down through the next cream and several other beads. So I even went through that diamond bead again. Okay, and what happens is you got to, again, work with your beads, make them do what you want them to do. All right, so now we have what's going to be an area to anchor our dangle and our earring hook eventually. So if you see what this looks like from the front, you don't really see it stick out too much. You just see a little bit of gold behind that pip bead, but it creates a really nice anchor point. So now what we have to do is we have to finish this off. And to finish it off, we need to tie off our threads. I'm going to show you how to do that. This is a project that's from start to finish that we're showing here. We do have other videos on beadaholic.com showing you how to tie off threads, but you know what? This is a little bit more of a complicated piece, and I want to show you just where you can do it. So just take your needle and thread and weave in a little bit. So you're just weaving it in. This has had a lot of passes go through it already, of course. And I'm behind a pip bead right now. So I did a little bit of weaving in, and now I'm just going to snake my thread under it, and I'm between two delicas, two cream delicas, which is perfect because it's a white thread, and I'm making a little loop. I'm going to go through my little loop and pull down to tie a knot. So there's a little knot hidden there, and I'm actually going to do another one at that same spot just for good measure. So I've got two knots in there. And now I'm gonna just go through. That bead again, and another bead next to it. I just don't ever like cutting my thread right at the knot. So I pull that, and it actually pulls that knot away and in, and now I can snip this thread. You can weave in your thread a little bit more if you would like to. This one I felt was already woven in pretty good because I started it here and I just went all the way around, but if you want, you could do a little bit more than that. All right, and then just trim your thread. Okay, so we still have one tail left to trim. So this is where you left enough for you to come back to it later. So we're going to go ahead and re-thread our needle onto this tail. And the trick, if you need to make your thread a little flatter, is to just kind of pinch it with your fingernail. That always tends to work well. Okay, so I've got my needle back on. Okay, so I'm on the back side of this now. Pip beads are out front. And I'm going to go ahead, go in the same direction that it was going originally, pull it, and I'm gonna go under some of my threads and create a little loop. Go through the little loop and pull, and you see a little knot there. Now I'm gonna go through my diamond bead. Pull that so the little knot gets hidden. And I'm gonna do another little knot. Now I didn't do two knots in the same spot for this one because this is not truly the back side. I mean, I am going from the back side to do this, but it's not like it's hidden behind a pip bead. So in case my knot ended up a little bit bigger and clunkier, I wanted to do them in two separate spots. Okay, so there we go. I just tied another one. And you can weave this in as much as you want on this as well. But you see, when you look at our front, this is what we've got now. Okay. And I feel like just doing another one. This was a lot of bead weaving right here. So I'm just gonna do one more. Do as many as you feel comfortable with. Everyone's different. Some people only do one, some do four or five. All right, and when you feel you've got what you want, just trim it off. And we're on the back side of the yarn. Okay, yay, our bead woven piece is done. So this is what it looks like as our focal. And let's compare it to our original one. And they should be identical. All right, so let's turn this pretty medallion into a wearable earring. Okay, what do we need to do? So what we're going to do is we are going to create our connector piece, which you see here in the example. So if you look at this, you'll notice a couple different things. The eye pin that I'm creating has a smaller loop up top and a larger one down at the bottom. The larger one is facing forward. The smaller one is off to the side. And I did that because I like the look of having a loop here and a loop up here at the earring hook. Now our earring hook loop actually comes like this knot. So we wanna twist it. So we're gonna take our pliers. We've got our nice chain nose pliers and we're just gonna take this loop, gonna grab it, very carefully twist it forward. Okay, so now that loop is facing forward. Oops. So now that's ready to go. Let's go ahead and take our eye pin and turn it into a head pin. There's the eye, we're just gonna cut it off. And that gives us a nice straight piece of 22 gauge wire. We're going to take our lovely wire looping pliers and we're gonna make a loop. I'm gonna do it a little down, further down because if I did it too far up and my loop was too small, it would not go through my Delica. I did a little experiment and that is what I learned. So take your wire and grab it into your pliers and squeeze. Does some of the work for you and bend over. Bend over some more and then kink it back. Let's see what we got. Yep, we have a little loop. So it's about the same size. It's actually a little bit big. I might want to redo that. So let me see if I can redo it and just do it from this piece of wire. Okay, I want them to match. So I went a little too far down. So I'm just going to do this again and see if I can make them look about the same size. Okay, how does that one look? Does that look a little... Yes, much, much better. Okay, so to open it, you're gonna open it just like a jump ring or just like a eye pin, just twist it open. We're gonna take our piece right here and we've got that set of, where we're at right now is where we have that little archway of three Mayuki Delicas in gold. Okay, we're going to take it and scoot it through the top one. So it's a hook, hooray. Okay, now what we're gonna do is close it on up. And you could do this part first and have your piece all done, or you can do it as you go. But I'm stringing on a 4mm bicone. It's that light turquoise prestige one. And now I want a smaller loop. So right above my bicone, I've got my wire looping pliers. Gonna squeeze it, twist it. Okay, now let's see if we can get that shot for you. You can see it's in there. And we pull it over. And when we pull it out, this is what we've got. So now right where it crisscrosses, right where it overlaps, we're gonna trim it. Okay, so that is now trimmed. You can do all the straightening you wanna do. Okay, now we need to open it up and put our earring hook on. So we're gonna open it. And let's see if I can do this correctly with the right orientation. Okay, and I closed it back up. Let's see what we got. Matching earring. So I love making earrings. I can honestly admit sometimes when you make up a design, it can be a little hard to make the second one. I don't know if everyone else experiences that as well. It's so much fun creating the first one. And then you're like, well, how did I do that? So I hope you enjoy this design right here. These are the Laguna earrings, and they do feature the pretty, pretty prestige crystals, the pip beads, the diamond beads, which I kept calling triangle beads, and some Mayuki delicas. So I think you could also probably put these together as a bracelet as well. If you made a whole bunch of these, it'd be really pretty to connect them as a bracelet. So that's another variation you can do. Maybe I'll do that someday as well. But for now, we have our earrings. So you can find other projects like this and other videos at beadaholic.com. So please remember to subscribe to always see the latest videos and the latest beads. Thanks for watching, everyone.